Hello, welcome to B4U Star Stop. And the boy should have been a basketball player. He's so tall. But he has, actually, you know, when you say gentle giants, na, aise hota hai jaise bodybuilding wale, aur awaaz aise aaram se nikalte. Shaquil O'Neal was one such gentle giant. He's actually like a gentle giant because the songs that he sings are very romantic style. And you know, if you're in Mumbai right now, it's all raining and it's very romantic wala feel. Arjun Kanungo, thanks so much for joining, buddy.
Always great to join you, man.
Isn't that true, man? You're like this gentle giant. I mean, when you look at you, you probably think like a very powerful, big boy coming with a big, strong voice, but no.
I can change my voice to a bhari voice. But I don't talk like this.
But hai tumhara ek romantic feel. Tumhari zindagi mein tum romantic aadmi ho.
Hoon, lekin I think that I'm more romantic about my work than anything else. I'm a workaholic. So romance ke liye itna time nahi milta.
नहीं तुम्हारे गाने में लेकिन वो बड़ा आता है. सो व्हेन यू वर यंगर व्हेन यू वर सिंगिंग लाइक आई ऑलवेज सेड योर वॉइस इज वेरी फ्यू कैन डू द बीजीज इंस्पायर्ड फॉल्सेटो. सो डिड यू लाइक फाइंड डिफरेंट वॉइसेस ऑफ योर्स एंड देन सेटल ऑन वन पर्टिकुलर काइंड?
बचपन में मैंने तो सीखी नहीं थी म्यूजिक, ऐसे नहीं कि मैंने ट्रेनिंग बहुत जल्द मतलब कम उम्र से की थी. आई स्टार्टेड ओनली व्हेन आई वाज 18. सो एट दैट टाइम आई हैड नो आइडिया. आई हैड टू डाइव लाइक फेस फर्स्ट इनटू इट, राइट? But when you start at 18, everybody is like, क्या करोगे तुम? पहले तो घर पे you face lot of friction कि music कैसे करोगे? You know, like it's always like not like you can't do it, but कैसे क्या plan?
It's very difficult.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Plan fair to ask also. I'm not saying no. लेकिन the question was क्या करोगे? क्या plan क्या है? And I never had an answer. I had no idea. और I just started singing naturally, जो मुझे अच्छा लगता था, and that was like you said the Bee Gees and the
So you were able to hit those high notes with the false voice?
Not always.
Bachpan se?
Nahin.
Okay.
Not always. But I loved it.
Okay.
So I mean, there was always something to aspire towards. Haan ki, wo high awaaz ko main, I think in rock music, man, it's got a place in a rock musician's heart.
Yeah.
Ki high notes jo ga sakta hai, wo actually ga sakta hai. You know, so I think the early years were spent in doing that.
And then eventually, did you feel comfortable with that? Did you, like, was there a singer that you used to really like in the rock scene abroad also that you felt that, you know, I like the style of this guy?
I think so many. Yeah. Michael Jackson.
Oh man.
I mean, you know, I'll tell you something very scary. I went for a show recently. It was a corporate show. After the show, I met all the guys in the audience in Delhi. And youngsters, they have no idea who Michael Jackson is.
Wow.
That to me is shocking.
They don't know who Michael Jackson is.
Age,
wow.
People my age in their like mid to early, late 20s, don't know who Michael Jackson is.
Shit.
Like, it's crazy. Like,
no, but I agree with you. Because there's a lot of people in my office that I work in, they don't know the Matrix film. They said, Matrix? Sir, Matrix kya hai? I said, did you just say, what is the Matrix?
No, but it's unbelievable to me that people don't know someone like Michael Jackson. Like, he is the biggest artist of all time.
Yeah.
You know, so for me, it's shocking. Like, I can understand the youngsters who are absolutely like 10-15 saal ke bachche, unko nahi aata hai. Matlab, lekin my age, we used to love Michael Jackson.
Oh, lived by it. Yeah.
Exactly. So I mean, Michael Jackson was there. Then there was Bruce Dickinson from Iron Maiden.
Ah, yeah.
Uski to high notes to kuch alag hi hai. Aisa karke aata tha,
you know, so most of the guys who used to hit high notes used to like?
I used to like them. I used to like the music. Wo style hi aisa tha ki rock music mein na wo gaate hi uche the. तो मुझे रॉक म्यूजिक पसंद था तो आई वाज एक्सपोज्ड टू दैट मोर.
वेरी डिफिकल्ट यू नो बिकॉज़ आई यूज्ड टू कम फ्रॉम अ कॉन्वेंट स्कूल वेयर वी यूज्ड टू सिंग ग्रीस लाइटनिंग एंड ऑल दीज सॉन्ग्स यू नो एंड द बॉयज दैट कुड सिंग हाई हुज वॉइस हैडन क्रैक्ड बाय देन दे वर अ सेपरेट ग्रुप. योर वॉइस नेवर क्रैक्ड क्या बचपन में 14 15 पैसा
क्रैक तो हुआ था. आई रिमेंबर बीइंग टीज्ड वेरी बैडली बाय आई हैव अंकल्स हु आर मामास हु आर वेरी like brutal. So they were like very, made me very aware that mari awaaz phat rahi hai.
And guess who became a singer 5 years later?
Yeah, I mean, it was, you know what, there was a period where I was doing classical music.
Wow.
Aur wo classical music mein mere jo guruji the wo kehte the ki agar aap low mein nahi ga sakte ho to high mein gaane ka kuch matlab hi nahi hota kyunki low mein awaaz banti hai wahan par.
अच्छा.
सो यू मेड मी डू एवरी डे वी शुड सिट एंड वो एक्चुअली यू नो हाउ यू स्टार्ट विद यू हैव अ स्केल.
या
तो माय स्केल वाज एनीवे वेरी हाई फॉर अ गाय.
या
इन क्लासिकल म्यूजिक दे से काली सॉरी सफेद एक इज यूजुअली द मैन स्केल.
ओके.
तो माइन वाज काली दो व्हिच वाज एक्चुअली फॉर विमेन स्टार्ट ऑफ एज.
अच्छा.
And he brought it down, brought it down, brought it down till I got to a man scale. And then he was like, he was like, yeah. And I was like, I can even hit those notes.
Yeah, yeah.
But I feel comfortable singing high.
Wow.
Yeah. So, I mean, I remember that.
So, was it difficult bringing your scale down? And because everything with you seemed very organic. Yeah. So, was that a tough process?
I think everything has kind of made me who I am, you know. So, it's been like a mix. So he would make me do like how we have Sa-re-ga-ma-ba-da-ni-sa. So we had the lower octave, so we'd go Sa-ni-sa-ni-da-pa-ma-ga. Oh. And every day we'd go Sa-ni-da-pa-ma-ga. Every day, like till I couldn't hit the note.
Wow.
And then he would stretch it and stretch it. We did it for almost like 3 years.
Wow, so
and that helped. But
hardcore riyaz.
Yeah, he made me change the way my voice, he made my voice sound different.
So it can change. I've seen some singers change it.
Absolutely. I think from the first time I sang playback, which was, I think, in Go Go Agon, where it's a very high song again,
yeah,
to what I sang with Mithun Sir, which is, I think, 2016,
yeah,
end of 2016, it's a different voice. I can't recognize my voice in the early songs.
Wow.
Yeah, it's a big difference. Big difference.
So it's not just auto-tune. a lot of people actually can switch and change their voice. Do singers, I want to ask you, do they bother about changing or doing as much riyaz now because technology is at their disposal?
You know what, it's a mix. I think that people who are technologically savvy and who have done riyaz are the guys who are
the
killing
best.
It.
Yeah.
You know, like you look at the top guys, they're great at singing and technology. So now it's become like, you know, like how in sport, at one time,
yeah,
there was all these steroids.
Yeah, yeah.
Auto-tune is the steroid of singing.
How much can it actually change you? You're a great programmer yourself.
Right.
So if you're like an okay singer, can it really make you a much better singer? Because a lot of stars sometimes sing and people are saying, sab auto-tune. I was going like, aisa nahi hota. So even if it's steroids, body to banani padti. Body ko better karne ke liye, logo ne ye use kiya hai.
So let's just say that you can become Adele with auto-tune. It's,
really?
Yeah. It's like, the thing in the studio is that you don't have to sing the whole thing. You can sing one word. And then someone will stitch it all together and make it a song. It's,
really?
It's crazy what you can do with a computer. It's crazy.
I need to hire better producers. So I can write a single. Absolutely.
Why can't you write
a single? And I have a big voice.
You just have to have a basic sense of music. Like just ki aap.
Can I do Sare Gama for you?
Do it.
Sare Gama Pa Dha Ni Sa.
Adele.
मेरा जो ख्वाब और सपना था एक गाना गाने का
अडेल फॉर श्योर
अडेल बन जाऊंगा मैं अभी मैं शोज करूंगा एज अ सिंगर देखो नाउ दिस इज व्हाट आई वाज वेटिंग फॉर फॉर समवन टू टेल मी दैट इट कैन बी डन देयर इज अ ट्रैक ऑफ हिज दैट इज हिटिंग द यू नो एयरवेव्स एवरी 15 मिनट्स एंड यू नो व्हेनेवर यू सिंग अ सॉन्ग व्हाई आई ब्रॉट दिस एंटायर कन्वर्सेशन अप इज बिकॉज इट्स अ ब्यूटीफुल ट्रैक एंड इट्स अ वेरी इंटरनेशनल साउंडिंग ट्रैक एंड अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल डोंट नो दैट ही इज सो गुड विद making a song sound gross and not just singing. Aaya Na Tu, he's going to sing for us. In just a bit, don't go anywhere. All right, you're back on Star Stop with a man who's always ahead of the game. Arjun Kanungo, thanks so much for joining, buddy.
Thank you, man, for having me.
This is a little, small, beautiful looking guitar. Is this like a normal guitar?
It's like a normal guitar, but it's like a mini version of a normal guitar. I can travel around.
You get this everywhere or?
I got this like in a small store in like the US when I was there and it was so cheap and I had to buy it. It was like so beautiful and so like cheap.
And here I was thinking like it's really expensive, like $1 million and all.
You don't need $1 million to make a good song, man.
Well, that's true actually. So, you know, so he's here and he's got this amazing track in which you're going to talk about. And if you're on the airwaves in Mumbai, it's really caught on. A, because of it's romantic. B, the weather just makes it sound so good. And there's a very international feel to it. So, Aaya Na Tu, which is trending pretty high, right?
I think it's the number one pop song in the country today.
That's fantastic. You know, it's a testament to his belief in this kind of music, belief in wanting to do things his own way. So, let's have it, buddy.
Tum kabhi na kahoge kyun na hum hi ye bol de ho kahan ye batao हम वहाँ चल के आ जाएंगे भीगे भीगे मौसम के लेते जहाँ तेरे मेरे रास्ते मिले थे जहाँ बाहों में तेरी दिन ढले थे जहाँ आ गया मैं वहाँ मगर
soothing number. Where did you get this in your head from? You know, like, was...
It's a melody that I've lived with for almost 5 years. I'm not kidding.
Why?
Because I've never found the lyrics for it. You know, some melodies, you think that they're beautiful and you want to hold on to them, but they have to have the right lyrics.
Yeah.
Lyrics bahut zaruri hai gaane mein. I think a song, a hit song, any hit song, is made up of two things, lyrics and melody. That's it. Poetry and melody.
Yeah.
You know, and I think...
Are you good with coming up with lyrics at a...
English mein, lekin Hindi mein, mujhe, I don't have that skill.
Yeah.
It's not a talent, it's a skill. Wo, you have to grow up with it. You know, wo bachpana mein nahi thi. I was Bombay boy. Main Bombay Scottish school. Jahan par Hindi bolte.
He was an urban boy.
Bolte nahi the hum. My first girlfriend in school, she was like, she used to call her
Hindi.
No, she used to.
Bhaya. Bhaya.
She was a Catholic girl and she used to be like, driver saab, aap yahan par khad raha.
You know, so there's this spoof that they do on a lot of these Delhi girls. Bhaiya, aap mera yoga class ka leke aao na please, mere liye.
But that's all of South Bombay. Yeah.
Yeah, well, it's a lot of sometimes even suburbs of Mumbai. So,
yeah.
I mean, when you give somebody else to write your thoughts down, is that easy to? Does it match?
You have to like explain to them what you want. Mm. Like a good song is always a collaboration between the composer and the lyricist. Like Kunal, the guy who wrote this song, Kunal Verma. Brilliant lyricist. He wrote Hasi Ban Gaye.
Oh, I love that song.
Yeah, beautiful songs he's written. And so I have a great relationship with him in the sense that if I tell him something, we call him the Rajdhani. Because he writes songs in like that. Ittu mein likhta hai wo. And he's literally like, you give him an idea. Aaya Na Tu was written like that. It was written in like 30 minutes flat. So he was like, I was like, you know, I have this melody.
Even the hook line wasn't there. Oh my god.
And he was like, Aaya Na Tu. And he can't sing very well. But he was like, Aaya Na Tu. Aaya Na Tu. I was like, bro, that's perfect. You know, that's like the whole feel of the song in like one more. And that's the litmus test. If you want to know how good a song is, if you hear it once, you should know the name of the song.
Well, it happened with me also. You know, the first time I heard it on radio, in fact, we were one of the first stations when I do my radio show and I played it out there. And it just had this lovely feel to it. Everybody sitting around saying, yeah, but I international feel. And that was what it is. This guitaring piece also sounded very nice. It's very soothing with it. This is different to your Baki Bate and all those kind of, you know, the hectic ones that you've done in the past.
Right.
So actually speaking, even though you have a very romantic voice, you've not done this for a while.
Yeah, it's a creative direction that I was with people who thought that was my vibe.
Yeah.
Lekin, I'll be very honest. I think the ballad vibe is my vibe. I think I'm that guy, you know. So even though I don't want to put myself in a box, I think I do both pretty decently. But on a personal level, I like these kind of songs more. Yeah, you know, I would listen to it more. Usme substance zyada hai. They last longer. Jaise meri ek gana tha mera Fursat. That song, people are raving about it till today. I still get messages saying that, "Arey, aapka jo gana tha Fursat, main abhi bhi roz sunti hu, 10 bar sunti hu, ye karti hu." Like it's that song has like a cult following.
I guess it grows on.
Yeah.
You know, if I think of him, if you had to choose one member of say the old Backstreet Boys, you'd be like Nick Carter, na?
No.
who would you be? So imagine if you had to, would you be AJ or would you be? Sare naam nahi aate, but your singing is like Nick Carter, na?
I don't think so, man.
You'd be like
I'm a huge JT fan, Justin Timberlake, all the way. So he's not a Backstreet Boy,
but
he's like from NSYNC. But I remember, you know, I realized how good these as they were as singers.
Yeah.
You know, boy band is a local.
Everyone thinks like
they gaani sakte. There's one special that they did long, like in the 90s. I was like 10, and they were like they did a special which was like a Christmas special.
Yeah.
They were singing Christmas carols.
Yeah.
Without any instrumentation. Only a choir
just
situation.
Just like harmonizing.
A cappella.
Wow.
Incredible. You have to look this up if you go onto YouTube.
Okay.
Just YouTube NSYNC.
Christmas special.
Acapella live.
Wow.
Acapella live.
Check it.
Incredible. Incredible. Like you won't believe it's the same guys.
Wow.
Harmonizing and they're so on pitch. And because there's no instruments, it's not lip sync for sure. You know?
Yeah, and plus it was at a time and maybe, you know, I guess this wasn't, live singing was in.
Right.
Do you think there could ever be a boy band in India? I mean, we had one, you know, I mean, like the boys to me, I mean, the band of boys, they've got their own feel to it. But do you think that we can ever, the girl bands, I still feel can happen. But I don't think a boys band can happen.
Why do you think so?
But I don't think that there are enough male singers out there who are singing pop.
Yaar, abhi filhal, I'm looking for a female singer for my band. I can't find one.
Really?
I've been looking for 6 months. I want someone who's like overall talented, you know, who can dance, sing, act. Because what we want to do in our live shows is we want to create a production.
Yeah.
Or usko dhoondna matlab yaar.
But one more thing with YouTube and all, there must be so many coming.
Yeah, no, there are lots, but you know, they can't sing live, yaar.
Acha, wo studio
live ka gaane matlab.
We were discussing auto-tune mein kaise main bhi Adele ki tarah sound kar sakta hu.
Yaar, you know, I have a very earlier when I used to meet these people, I saw them live and I was like, yaar, yehi hogi. Yehi hai, ye band mein mere next, abhi, she's going to be in my next performance. And then I would meet them and I would ask them to sing anything. Simple, twinkle, twinkle, little star bhi gawa do na, toh phir aise auto-tune lagana padta hai na. Full pe lagana padta.
What is your audition song? Is like that you like, you know, there was somewhere over the rainbow. Purane zamane mein they used to say if you could sing this song well.
It's a difficult song. Yeah.
Very difficult. So yeah. They said this was the perfect singing audition.
Right.
What is the audition that you have? Like if somebody sings can sing this well, wo ga sakta hai.
I think it's just any song. If you can really like, see, ek to Indian music is very hard.
Yeah.
Super difficult. Even pop music. बहुत मुश्किल है गाना कोई का गाने तो बहुत मुश्किल है लाइक आई रिमेंबर आई वाज लिसनिंग टू लाइक आफ्टर मेनी इयर्स आई हर्ड तू ही रे आफ्टर वेरी लॉन्ग तू ही रे तेरे बिना मैं कैसे जीऊं इट्स अ वेरी सिंपल स्वीट मेलोडी बट टू पुट योर सोल इनटू इट ना यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड म्यूजिक सो एक तो मुश्किल है गाना स्किल्स नहीं है तो फिर कैसे गाओगे यार इट्स वेरी स्केरी
सर आप पोस्ट में कर देना मैं पोस्ट में कर देना
ऐसे नहीं कि हम लोग ऑटो ट्यून नहीं करते हैं ऑफ कोर्स वी यूज ऑटो ट्यून बट वी फील दैट इवन इफ आई एम नॉट द बेस्ट सिंगर इन द वर्ल्ड आई एम रियली नॉट सिंग दैट एट ऑल गाइस डोंट हेट ऑन मी लेकिन मैं ये कह सकता हूँ कि मैं कोशिश तो जरूर करता हूँ कि जितना प्रैक्टिस हो जाए जितना ऑटो ट्यून पे कम डिपेंड करना हो ना आई डेफिनेटली ट्राई टू डू दैट सो आई फाइंड दी सिंगर्स यू नो व्हाट दे डू दे विल बुक अ स्टूडियो फॉर द होल डे
अच्छा।
पूरा दिन बुक करेंगे और फिर गाते रहेंगे जब तक एक लाइन अच्छा ना हो फिर एक लाइन को ऐसे लगा देंगे फिर दूसरे लाइन कर देंगे ऐसा पूरा दिन चल जाता है यार
आई एम गेटिंग वेरी एक्साइटेड सर मैं दो दिन स्टूडियो बुक कर दूंगा एक एक वर्ड करके दो दिन में गाना बन जाएगा एंड आई एम गोना कम टू अर्जुन ओनली फॉर ऑल द एक्सपर्ट एडवाइस बट व्हाई नो फिल्म्स नाउ आई वांट टू कम टू द बिगेस्ट क्वेश्चन दैट पीपल वांट टू आस्क इज हैव यू पुट असाइड इन योर हेड that you want to be a film and playback singer anymore?
It's a very sensitive topic, outside and inside. I think for two people also, ki, for my family also, it's like, yaar, itne album gaane kar rahe ho, ek film ka gaana kar lo, kyun nahi karte ho? Kyun nahi ki baat nahi hai, kab karna hai, wo is the right question to ask. Kyunki I feel like, ek to, dude, if you have been in the film circuit, you'll know how difficult it is
very
to do.
Yeah.
It's very hard.
You probably sung 20 songs in the year and कोई बाहर निकलता भी नहीं है।
I'm telling you, कभी-कभी तो confirmation भी दे देते हैं फिर भी नहीं निकलता। It's the recently I did a film.
Yeah.
And I did the music for the film. They paid me for the film. पैसे भी मिल गए।
अच्छा।
पैसे मिल गए, सब कुछ मिल गया, dates मिल गए, promotions के सब कुछ मिल गए। फिल्म निकल गया, गाने नहीं है फिल्म में। आज तक ये क्या हो गया यार? Premiere के लिए बुला दिया। It's like the thing is this film is that I want to do it on my own terms and I'm willing to wait. The thing with pop music and non-film music is that it comes with a shelf life. Until I'm cool, until I'm current,
yeah,
I can do pop.
Okay.
You know, once you cross that, I've got like, I would say like 7-8 years max. You know, because once you cross that threshold where, unless you're a rapper, rappers,
no, Baba Sehgal is still rapping.
Rappers can go. They are intrinsically cool.
Yeah.
Like, unless you're a rapper, you can... you end up being like, you know, very easily replaced in pop. Culture hai na, abhi pop culture to badalte rehta hai.
Correct,
aapki generation ka jo culture hai, wo aaj ka culture nahi hai. Matlab, aapke nahi, you're in my generation only. I'm saying...
Maine bahut generation dekh li hai.
I'm saying in general, if you look at like, I'm looking at so many artists from the 90s, like Baba Sehgal you spoke about. I think Baba Sehgal's cultures, the cultural...
but he sings on from Butter Chicken to anything.
No, but that's what I mean. At that time, if he released a song, Chezwan Chicken, man, people would go mad. You know what I mean? Like, he would slam it.
Yeah.
They're going to the gym. Like, so I like that stuff. I think it's funny. I think it's super cool.
Yeah, he's so much fun.
So I listen to his stuff. But like, to a new kid, they're like, ye kya parody
hai?
That's true. You know,
actually, because it's Baba Sehgal, and every morning, Hi Salil, yo, what's up? Upar dekh, tera ho top. You know, he sent me all these
things. I'll give you an example. Dinchak Pooja.
Oh. Abhi, that's pop culture. But.
That's pop culture. Yeah, that's man. Pop culture all the way.
Even though I want to slap the TV. Because TV ko main kuch kar sakta ho at least.
Because Dhinchak Pooja today will come in with the song Selfie Maine Li. And we know the lyrics. That's the scary part. I know the whole song. Yeah, like, I don't want to know it, but I know the whole damn song.
You know, and I love her because... I tell you why I love her.
More power to her. No doubt. Yeah. I'm not hating on her. I'm just saying that that is pop culture.
Yeah, man.
So I could never do that. I'm already outdated in that sense. You know, like, I believe that good work is important.
Sir, I'm with you. You know? I can never be part of that pop culture, for sure.
Yeah, yeah. No, I'll support it. If Dhinchak Pooja, if you need a shout out from me ever, I'm willing to give it to you whenever.
She's too cool. But she's taking a video in a party that she's gone to. Dekho mere saath kaun kaun hai. Then they told her, video band karo, video band karo. So main dikha nahi duniya ko kaun kaun tumhare saath video hai. Before we come got the guitar, yeah, I want to be singing another lovely track of yours.
Sure,
you
sure.
Choose anyone. But Aaya Na Tu is the one that, you know, he's already sung. Make sure you go check that out. In case you haven't, you're already missing out. Like he said, it's already number one on the pop song chart. So let's go check it.
So Aaya Na Tu is, of course, the song that we're here to promote and show you guys. And you can check that out on YouTube on the EMI India channel, yeah. EMI Records India channel. And it's doing phenomenally well. We're almost at now 25 million views in less than 14-15 days, I think.
That's really big.
Insane. We're
doing, for a pop song, it's fantastic.
Yeah, yeah. We're doing 1 million views a day, more or less.
Wow.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. So, I mean, even in from all across the board, we're on every chart. But this is a song I want to sing for you, which I made with Mithun in 2017. It's 16, 17, I don't remember now. But it's a beautiful song he's written called Sanam Mere Sanam. And he got me to sing it, and I was very grateful for the opportunity because I love his music.
Yeah. Yeah.
तपते हुए सहरों में मिले आबशार जैसे मुझको तो है इस जहां में मिला तेरा प्यार ऐसे तपते हुए सहरों में मिले आबशार जैसे मुझको तो है इस जहां में मिला तेरा प्यार ऐसे सनम ये तेरा करम बना रहे यूं ही कभी ना हो ये कम सनम ये तेरा करम बना रहे यूं ही कभी ना हो ये कम.
He has a gift. And I do agree that, you know, this love ballad feel is much more you. Thanks so much, buddy, for joining me.
Thank you, man. Thank you for having me.
And I would say, you know, that, you know, we keep meeting each other so often now. But
we do, don't we? We meet each other like every week now.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. But I still learn something new from you every day. And like I said, so much more that you can learn also from artists. You've got to keep growing. And that's the best part of it, man. Make sure you go check out all the tracks and always support good music. Like I said, you can catch this interview on B4U Entertainment. It'll be out very soon. And if in case you're liking and sharing the B4U Entertainment channel, the bell icon will always tell you when the new interview is up. Take care and see you soon.